In a previous video, Mikaël Mayer, a PhD candidate of the IC school at EPFL, told us about a program he's been developing that writes clean code based on interactions you have with a PowerPoint-like interface. This means that we now have an easy-to-modify source code that we did not write, and that's pretty cool.
There are some websites already offering the opportunity to modify the code. For example, if you use WordPress, you can always modify the PHP source, right? But actually, everything is stored in the data. So if you have to write the code yourself, you have almost nothing to start with. You have to read the API and so on.
The API, or Application Programming Interface, is the set of ways you can interact with the source code of WordPress. And they are, let's say, not super user-friendly.
But what now if the code is completely obfuscated with strange variable names, with multiple closures that you don't understand?
Yes, as a WordPress user, I can vouch for this. I have spent countless hours and hours trying to understand some of its API. Not user-friendly.
We have to make sure that the code remains readable by a user, maybe because we add some comments, so that the user can have a look at the code and more or less quickly understand the code so that he can modify it at the end. This is what we want to do.
However, writing easy to understand source code is already very difficult for humans. Now, automating that, well, this is a big challenge.
To be able to reason about the code requires very advanced tools, because you need to be able to refactor the code automatically. For example, if you want to make something unique, you need to insert a variable. You need maybe to insert some function which abstract things. And this is very hard for the computer because it doesn't know everything at all about the code. So you have to teach him some semantics of the code yourself and how to perhaps the best practices about modifying the code so that it stays readable, for example.
So basically, you need to somehow teach the computer what a good, clean source code is. But this is not enough.
To be able to backtrack, to go back to the code, actually what we did is we first run the code. So we parse the code, we compile the code, we run the code, we translate the result to a web page. And now if I change the web page, the problem is how to come up with the right program, because now we just have an output and we have the new output. And we have nothing. So actually what we do in advance is that we re-execute the program from the source code up to the output, but this time we record which steps were performed. So now if I have a string, let's say a language colon en, or like here, language colon en, actually I will exactly know where this string comes from.
If you've ever written code, you know exactly what he's talking about. How many hours have I spent trying to figure out where this string or that digit come from?
So it will execute the program, but instead of storing just strings, actually it will store an expression which is concatenation of two strings.
And this is clever because if we just concatenated the two strings, we would lose the information about the fact that they really were two strings to start with.
Every concatenation of two strings, you do not flatten it, you still keep the concatenation of two strings. So at the end, you know that every string has been created through some string in the program.
And this is very useful to debugging or to figuring out what modifications should be made to obtain what we want to obtain. However, there is one big difficulty along the way. Namely, there usually are several different ways to modify the source code to obtain what we want to obtain.
Let's say I want to create a new slide. Okay, so by default, it might be that you will just duplicate everything. So the problem is that if I start to modify something, it will change it in the other slide, which you don't want because you want to something new. And even if you change the title, maybe you don't want that the title changes. So the big breakthrough right now would be to have come up with a way that is standard and that is easy to use, so that the computer will ask questions so that, you duplicated this, but do you intend to do something new? Because in the code, it will translate to creating new variables. And depending on the complexity on how you created the slides, if you have multiple functions calling each other, Actually, this could result in a function with more arguments.
Yes, because when you copy-paste a whole slide, you usually want to reuse exactly some parts of the slide and just delete the others. But if you delete something in the new copy-pasted slide, does that mean that you want to delete the exact corresponding thing in the previous slide? This is really not clear. And yet, the answer to this hypothetical question has strong implications to the way the source code should be updated to copy-paste the slide we started with.
I came up with a very simple scenario in which I had like 7 different ways of updating the code. So one of the big challenges would be how to select among all this code which one would be the most readable, the most customizable for the user so that he could continue to work with.
And that's where I had to ask, wouldn't machine learning be useful in guessing what the user would want his source codes to be like?
Machine learning at some point will be a way that we might use, either to learn, because refactoring will have different names, for example, and if we have a lot of users using this, we could see if a user likes which one they like more, and then from this, we learn which one we should produce in the code. So of course, at some point, machine learning will help at some point.
So basically, automated code factoring is definitely something that looks very promising for the future. However, it does raise many very difficult challenges for computer science researchers. How long would it take to solve them all?
I think it will take at least 10 to 15 years until we see some of this software where you can edit both appearing in the market.
In some sense, it boils down to the saying, your wish is my command.
But in the background, it should create some code, some full code that you can abstract and you can work with.